guys, and welcome back to my channel. This entire video is basically, hey Pecos, you want to join? How about my dog joins? He has to be inside for reasons we can talk about later, but this video is basically like a spur of the moment type of deal. Haven't posted a video for 3 weeks. My bad.
Yeah, see, that's a no-no.
That's a no-no. Yeah, I didn't mean to do that. I basically have been so busy with the planner launch and the planner's going super, super crazy. Is this what it's like to have a kid? But with the planners getting super crazy and the orders getting crazy, so I've been, you know, all excuses aside, I've literally been so busy, guys. And what's crazy is I'm not even in the middle of my barrel racing season. If I was going through all of this right now and I was running barrels, I don't even know what would happen. I'd probably have a mental breakdown. Anyways, guys, so today what I'm talking about is Legacy, which if you guys haven't been following my YouTube channel, you don't know what this horse is, but I basically brought her on like a year and a half ago. I brought her onto my team as a surrogate for Moonshine, my main barrel horse. My original goal was to, like I said, have her be the surrogate, which if you don't know what that means have her be the mom to Moonshine's baby so that I could always ride Moonshine and not have to wait for her to be pregnant, have the baby. I have a full video that talks about her. You know what, honestly, in this video I'm just gonna link all the videos that I've talked about Legacy before, and that way if you really want to go into detail about what the journey was like with her and how all of that stuff was playing out, then you can go and look at that. Basically, I got her as a trade from a horse that I was training at the time. I didn't have the budget for a brood mare, so I just figured, you know what, a trade would actually make this work out really well. So I ended up trying to breed her because I also got a free breeding from a really nice stud from around here that I really like, and so I tried to get a free breeding also with her, tried to make all of that work out. I literally was in the middle of the spring, in the middle of breeding her. She did not want to get bred. Like, she, every time I took her there, she didn't want to do a live breeding, which basically just means she was just not accepting of it. So it got kind of difficult, and we got to the point to where we were like, okay, if we want her to be pregnant, she needs to do AI, which is artificial insemination, which is basically not a live breeding. It's when they inject her basically with frozen. Is this kid friendly? Anyway, so this is everything that Legacy has gone through in 2019. Once it got to the point to where we were thinking about having to do the AI, I was really hesitant about doing it because, guys, I'm 21. I have 3 horses. I do have a full-time job, which is the only thing that's keeping me above afloat, but I'm trying to have a successful barrel racing career and do things in the barrel racing and rodeo industry. And doing the more research that I did about having a baby and keeping a baby, it was just like, one, I don't have the resources for it. I don't have the money for it. I mean, you're talking like $3,000 to $5,000 just to get her. Look, my vet and I talked about it, and it wasn't going to be that much, so I was like, I am willing to pay for this. This is my future in a far baby, which I still do believe, like, if Moonshine did get bred to that horse, that it would come out with a really nice baby. But is it realistic for me right now? No way. None of that is realistic for me. And I was already like $1,000 or so down just by getting her ultrasounds and getting her ready for the breeding, getting her shots so that she could be ready for the breeding, getting her to the breeding. I was already a lot of money out without even her having the baby, even being pregnant. And so I was just like, this probably isn't the deal for me right now. So I put Legacy up on the market, and that is what got me to look at her papers. Originally, like I said, she was a surrogate. I didn't care about her papers or anything like that. So I looked into her papers and I realized, oh, so her whole family has won like over $1 million. Cool. She is a thoroughbred, or like a registered thoroughbred. She's got a very quarter horse body, so it's kind of different. I've had a quarter horse slash thoroughbred before, and he was like super tall, super leggy. She's not really like that. She's like almost the size of Moonshine, which is kind of weird for a thoroughbred, but she is. So her family won all of that on the track, which obviously just means they're fast. They have good lines. She just has really decent lines in her. And then I looked up her registered name online. Mind you guys, this is 9 months. 9 months. I'm not trying to get all on you right now, but what was I doing? Why did I just then look at the papers? I have no idea. I got to thinking, I was like, wow, if she's got this, and I was originally already thinking, even when I would just take her out to the fairgrounds with me and Moonshine, and I would let her just run around in the pen, I was like, thing. If I made her into a barrel horse, she would, I think, actually be faster than Moonshine. So here we are now. She still hasn't proven anything, but I have sent her off to training. Between the papers and like how everything worked out with her breeding, and like right now it's just not a broodmare market, so like selling her to get above with money just kind of wasn't realistic either. So I was like, okay, what exactly do I need to do with this horse right now? I decided, you know what, I think it's probably worth it for me to take the chance on her to try to make her into a barrel horse. So I decided to look for a trainer around here, and it was kind of a while before I decided on an actual trainer, but I asked for many suggestions from a lot of people. The most suggestions I got was from the guy that she is currently with. She's been there for probably like a week and a half. We're probably coming up on like 2 weeks now. Apparently she's doing really good. I also forgot to go back on what happened when I looked up her registered name. Her registered name is JJ's Half Pint. I looked that up, and I found videos of her from when she was like 3 to 5 years old. She was jumping, and I didn't even know that she had an English background. I didn't even know that she jumped. I ended up finding just like progress videos of her. I was kind of shook. I didn't even really know that she was that broke. Doing more research into her, I found a lot, and I was really excited to find all of that, and so that is like what also like helped me proceed into this. Yeah, Legacy has a very lengthy story. She's 10 years old, so she, I feel like, is in her prime right now. I'm really excited to see where it goes with her, but I wanted to make this video because I have made videos about her before. Lay down. Lay down, guys. And I'm gonna ride her for the first time literally ever tomorrow morning is when I'm gonna get on the back of her for the first time. And honestly, I'm a little bit nervous. I'm going to be including the video of that in this video, so you guys are gonna see it. It's going down. But I'm actually also super excited because my goal with her is to go to the WCBRA finals next year with her. You guys have seen on my very latest videos, I just went to the WCBRA finals with Moonshine, and it was so fun. So she has about until next September to be just like high loping through the pattern, which I think is very reasonable. But I'm gonna be documenting the whole experience, and this is why I wanted to make this entire video right now. I just honestly have a really good feeling about her no matter what. What's so crazy is she is already a diamond in the rough to me. I didn't even know. I just thought she was some broodmare. Like, you guys never know. In the rodeo industry, I'm always the person that's gonna be the advocate for the underdog. Always the person that's gonna be the advocate for the person that didn't come from a rodeo family. It's not that I'm against rodeo families or anything like that. That's nothing like that. It's just like, I know how hard it is to not come from one and to want everything that everybody else wants. You want the gold buckle. You want to be known in this industry. And it's like, it's very hard to do if you didn't come from that kind of family. So it's just like, I want to prove to you guys that it is possible to build a career or at least be happy in this industry. And even though you didn't come from a rodeo family, even though you don't have money, even though you live on a half an acre, I feel like in a lot of ways I kind of am the minority in rodeo, and that is why I'm so passionate about wanting to teach you guys. I'm going into a whole deeper story, but that's why I'm so passionate about it. Legacy turning out to be like this, I'm like, okay, I really genuinely believe that everything happens for a reason. So like with Legacy turning out to be the way that she has been and everything that's coming out of this, I'm like, oh, so this fits with my story. And it just makes me think, like, any person who's struggling the way that maybe you have struggled like me, or maybe you're struggling in a different way, I just always come back to the fact that you need to just keep pushing. Like, if you just keep pushing through, everything's gonna come together. And, you know, the good and the bad all happen for a reason, and they're all here to either teach you a lesson or to help you or both. So that's what's happening with Legacy right now, and like I said, that's why I want to share it right now, because she is exciting me in so many ways right now. Also, I don't think I really explained this. It also was on my 2019 goal list to find a prospect for 2020. It goes back to the fact that I don't really have the money to put into a very nice barrel prospect. And so I've looked into many options, like buying off the track and that kind of thing. And honestly, if Legacy didn't work out, I would have gone probably to the track. That kind of thing, like, or to cutting rejects or something like that. Because honestly, the barrel industry is just so expensive right now, and it's all in good reason. They're such nice horses, but people that can't afford that kind of thing, you can't. There's no way I will ever be able to buy $20,000 horse, a $50,000, like, It's just not realistic for me right now. If honestly, if that's a position that you're in and you're struggling, get scrappy. Find a way to do it and make it happen. Everything for me fell into place, but it was also because I really pursued it to make sure that everything was going to. I wrote my goal down every day and I basically manifested all of this stuff to happen. And so, anyways guys, so I'm going to go on to what happens tomorrow. We're gonna go ride her tomorrow. I hope that you guys end up liking it. I'll do a little closing in this video after that. But for now, I will see you guys later. Bye. We'll be right back.